Hello, all you wonderful fools. It's time for the Lizard Tea Show.
All aboard!
Here we go. Let's start the show. Hosted by Lizard T. Nintendo video games are the favorite ones for me. News and reviews, some gameplay too. Battling drones is what I do. M-I-Z-Z-A-H is the show by Lizard T. It's the show by Lizard T. Hey there, fools. Mr. T here to share my opinions on the recent news about Nintendo's failure to reach their sales goals and revising their forecast for the fiscal year. Please excuse the departure from my normal visual format as I wanted to get this video out as quickly as possible. To recap, in summation, if you haven't already heard, Nintendo has not done business nearly as they expected with the sales of Wii U and 3DS. While 3DS did and continues to sell extremely well, it's not selling as well as Nintendo expected. But it did end up as the best-selling piece of hardware for the year of 2013. So while it did not meet Nintendo's expectations, it's still number one by far, and the outcome, perhaps, speaks of Nintendo's overreaching expectations of it. The same could be said of the sales expectations of the Wii U. While the console sold extremely well under the enormous circumstances, reaching nearly 2 million consoles sold over the holidays, even with stiff competition from new consoles like Microsoft's Xbox One and PlayStation 4, there was no way it was going to sell good enough to give the install base enough of a boost to reach 9 million sold by the end of the fiscal year in March. Those expectations were just too damn high. Due to the fact that Nintendo didn't have the software to move a ton of consoles. Games that were supposed to be in Wii U's launch window didn't show up on the system till late summer and fall. First and second party titles like Pikmin 3 and The Wonderful 101, Wii Fit U and Wii Party U, along with third party titles like Deus Ex, Human Revolution, Director's Cut, and Rayman Legends were delayed several months or canceled, and that was the fault firstly of Nintendo for underestimating the development cycle of HD games and for counting on third party to deliver the games they promised. Wii U was unable to sustain its sales momentum from holiday 2012. People fail to remember Wii U sold over 3 million consoles during its first 2 months on the market. Even though it had a perceived weak launch lineup with no far and away killer app, poor marketing, consistent perceived consumer confusion that the gamepad was just an add-on for the Wii, and so on and so forth. Remember all those perceived problems? And despite that, it still managed to sell 3 million plus consoles in its first 2 months on the market. Now, imagine if the games released in the timely fashion that Nintendo was shooting for. What if Mario 3D World was the launch killer app, followed by Pikmin 3 in December 2012, Wii Fit U in January 2013, Rayman Legends in February, Game & Wario in March, with games like Crisis 3, Army of Two, Metro Last Light, and a good Aliens Colonial Marines, and a few others, propelling Wii U into the summer with the Wind Waker HD remake bundle released just after E3. And also with EA Sports and Need for Speed Rivals coming in the fall, with Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze in November and Mario Kart 8 in December 2013 to wrap it up. I believe that that was somewhat Nintendo's expectation. The details may be off by a little bit, but I feel like they might be a little closer than even I expect. But they had no backup plan when things fell through with third party and their own development woes. Had things gone off without a hitch, I wouldn't be surprised if Wii U would be sitting on a 10 million install base right now. And then the question would be, how could Xbox One and PS4 catch up in 2014 with Nintendo releasing Bayonetta 2, Super Smash Bros. X, Shin Megami Tensei Crossfire Emblem, Miyamoto's new IP, and Zelda Wii U, to name a few, to come out in 2014. That would have been amazing, but that didn't happen. Mistakes were made, and here we are. Although I went off on a tangent there, I needed to go out there to set up the rest of my analysis. Wii U is selling well below expectations, and when something is not selling well, armchair analysts come in droves to say everything they believe they know for sure is wrong with the product. Get rid of the gamepad, they say. It ain't powerful enough, they say. Not enough games have voice chat or party chat, they say. Ain't no trophy system, they say. Not enough hard drive space, they say. The virtual console sucks. Nintendo TV sucks. Nobody cares about asymmetric gameplay or the Miiverse, they say. And my favorite, people just think it's an add-on for the Wii, cause my mom said so. What the f***? But the only reason that truly matters is the one I alluded to in my prologue. Simply, the games weren't there. When the 3DS wasn't selling, the armchair analysts were out in droves again on why. Remember? It ain't powerful enough. Two-screen gaming is dead. No one cares about 3D. And on and on and on. But simply, the games weren't there. And the price was a bit too high, although it did sell well out the gate regardless of that price, and would have continued to sell again if the games were there. Nobody gave a shit about Radar Scope. A price cut, Ocarina of Time 3D, Mario Kart 7, and Mario 3D Land turned the system around. And the same could have happened for Wii U if the price was dropped in summer 2013 with Wind Waker HD, leading into the holidays with Mario 3D World and Mario Kart 8, along with the other things I mentioned, such as the third-party games that should have been there from EA and so on. And that's all it would have took. But this is ultimately how I feel about the Wii U shortcomings. I don't give a shit. I'm a fan of Nintendo's games, not Nintendo's financial reports. To the extent that I do care about Nintendo's money, that has to do with me caring that they stay in business and are profitable and prosperous enough to keep selling me what I care about most from them, their games. They are far from me worrying about their business. Why? Nintendo 64 had like 20 total games in its first year and launched with only 2 games, if I remember correctly, in the US. I believe there was Super Mario 64 and Wave Race 64. Correct me if I'm wrong. And that system went on to release some of the best games I ever played. It ultimately ended up with 32 million worldwide install base and still was an extremely profitable console for Nintendo. GameCube had an install base of 22 million and was also a very profitable console. So excuse me if I'm not worried. I don't need Nintendo to have the biggest market share and win the media-created console war or to win a damn popularity contest. All I need from them is their best games. And all Nintendo needs is to be profitable. They're not overly concerned with being number one either. That's not their philosophy. I don't get no check if they do so, so why should I give a shit about that? The overwhelming success of the Wii made Nintendo a bit arrogant and a bit complacent. But they deserve that arrogance and complacence after surviving 2 console cycles, being beaten down by Sony, and the many naysayers declaring doom for the underpowered white box with the funny name and weird waggle controller. They proved everyone wrong, and that little white box began to print money, and they started taking that for granted. And now, they are paying for that arrogance and that complacency. Well, I say good. The best and greatest outcomes come from struggle. You have these YouTube commentators who take themselves way too seriously, as I said before. And they want to badger you for not criticizing Nintendo enough vocally in your YouTube videos, because they think crying on YouTube will force Nintendo to change. Laughing my plastic black ass off. Criticism don't move Nintendo, especially criticism from nerds on the internet in front of their webcams. Like all businesses, the only shit that dictates and motivates business is motherfucking money. Nintendo's inadequacies and yes, failures is now affecting their bottom line. And money talks louder than any Nintendo hater. So I'm glad they are struggling. Cause I know they want and need to strive and continue as a business, and they'll do whatever it takes to return to success. You know what that means for me as a gamer? More and better games. They had their wake-up call with the 3DS, and they responded. Now it's Wii U's turn. 2014 will be an exciting time for Nintendo gamers. Yes, from the games that we know are coming, but now Nintendo's struggle will cause them to do some really exciting and compelling things to return to success. If you have strength in your will and resolve, out of your greatest struggles will come your greatest triumphs. And you can take that to the bank. And as it stands right now, Nintendo will continue to have a large bank account for a long time. So get your popcorn ready, fools. It's an exciting time to be a gamer. Have fun. Play your games, Nintendo fans. Nintendo been doomed since 1889. Yeah, that's a shout out, fools. Get ready for the ride and leave the doom and gloom analytics to the haters, the voodoo economics to Microsoft, cough, $2 billion loss, cough, and the popularity contest to Sony, because they've been making so much money, right? With their great market share and their high install bases. Nope. And oh yeah, cheap console and indie PC games on Steam is gonna end console gaming as we know it. Yeah, good luck with that. So don't fret, Nintendo enthusiast to Nintendo fanboy. Throughout history, struggle leads to fortune more often than not. Mr. T will see you fools in the Renaissance. Peace out. Oh yeah, one more thing. Play Nintendo, fools.